Hello, everyone. I'm Scott Steele, the chair of colorectal surgery at the Cleveland Clinic. And welcome to Quick Case, the series where I present a case and we have a special guest walk me through treatment and outcomes. So today's case involves a 59-year-old female with no previous history of colonic polyps or cancer. In January of 2021, she received a positive result on a self-administered test and underwent a colonoscopy in March. A large 10-centimeter by 9-centimeter multilobulated frond-like polypoid lesion was identified in the ascending colon, 7 to 10 centimeters from the ileocecal valve. The polyp was non-obstructive, but was occupying approximately two-thirds of the luminal circumference. Importantly, the lesion was not fixed or tethered to the underlying bowel wall, suggesting a benign condition. However, there could be the possibility of the lesion harboring invasive cancer in its interior portion. And now let's bring in Dr. Emery Gorgon, who is our director for lower GI for our Digestive Disease and Surgery Institute's Endoluminal Surgery Center. Dr. Gorgon, welcome to Quick Case. Walk us through how your team treated this.
This patient was from California, and by multiple healthcare providers, she was offered that the only option for her problem, for her condition, which was this large colonic lesion, colon lesion, was surgery, meaning colon removal, colon resection. And she was smart enough and intelligent enough that she did research, and looked for alternatives. And that led her to us, where we offered her endoluminal surgery, which means we go and treat lesions similar to hers transanally through the anus or natural orifices, which in this case obviously is the anus and rectum, and with a flexible scope and special tools, special knives, special graspers, we can do inside of the colon, inside of the intestine, major procedures and remove large lesions. We do not only remove these large lesions, but we can excise them in one piece in an en bloc fashion that allows us to really have a precise pathological analysis, a good histopathology, so we know if in the specimen there is any cancer cells or not, and if they are close to the margins and so forth. And that's really important for physicians to tailor our further recommendations for this type of lesions in patients. So in essence, this is a transanal, minimally invasive approach to remove large colonic lesions that are not amenable to be removed with conventional endoscopic or colonoscopic removal techniques. And I thank you for your time and listening.
Thank you, Dr. Gorgon. And for more information on treatment and referrals to Cleveland Clinic's Endoluminal Surgery Center, visit clevelandclinic.org/ELS. That's clevelandclinic.org/ELS. Until next time, thanks for watching Quick Case.